And they're off. Nobody is leaving. No pace at all in the early stages. Keystone Activator inherits command from the rail. Winning Mister is there in second. Muscle Hill moving up on the outside. He's showing the whip now by Sears into third. Racing in fourth is Braggart, who drops in on the pylon. Select Yankee is fifth. Then it's two lengths further back to Hurricane Big George. At the back is Caesar A. Blue Chip, who is the trailer. Muscle Hill up on the outside of Keystone Activator. These two stride for stride, and Muscle Hill pokes ahead in front, chased just a bit to clear the lead. The quarter was soft and just 29-1. Winning Mister is tracking the top pair in third. Braggart on the inside rides the cones in fourth. A length and a half further back to Select Yankee in fifth. Two lengths further to Hurricane Big George, and Caesar A. Blue Chip is gapped slightly at the back where he is the trailer. So Muscle Hill will have to do it on the lead here for Sears. Still a length clear. Keystone Activator, nice drafting spot there, second. Winning Mister showing the whip. Braggart is tipped out and underway. Select Yankee picks up cover to follow, as does Hurricane Big George, who's now third over. They reach the half in a minute flat, and the trailer is Caesar A. Blue Chip as they head on to the far turn. Muscle Hill trotting comfortably on the lead. Braggart is up to his wheel, applying some moderate pressure there with 3/8 to go. Keystone Activator trying to keep pace in the pocket is showing the whip there. Select Yankee is well spotted second up. Hurricane Big George third over. Winning Mister is jammed in on the inside. Then Caesar A. Blue Chip is the trailer, and it's Muscle Hill as they trot to the three-quarter marker. Braggart right there on the outside is racing in second. 1:29.4, the three-quarter time, and they come to the top of the stretch, and it's Muscle Hill. Muscle Hill still looking good on the lead under a Sears hand drive. He's showing the whip now with 1/8 of a mile to come, clear by two. Keystone Activator following on the inside second. Braggart is third, then Select Yankee. Winning Mister up the rail. Some late trot on the outside from Caesar A. Blue Chip, but it's Muscle Hill, and Muscle Hill beats the bias and wins it wrapped up from Keystone Activator. Up for third, Caesar A. Blue Chip. Braggart was off stride fourth. Then I believe Select Yankee from Winning Mister in 1:57.2. Keystone Activator following on the inside second. Braggart is third, then Select Yankee. Winning Mister up the rail. Some late trot on the outside from Caesar A. Blue Chip, but it's Muscle Hill, and Muscle Hill beats the bias and wins it wrapped up from Keystone Activator. Up for third, Caesar A. Blue Chip. Braggart was off stride 7-2 to win his Breeders' Crown elimination.
We let Brian Sears take the nice young colt back to the paddock here in this weather. Tommy Pontone and Greg Pecker here, Muscle Hill. You know, two-year-old trotting colt like this, it allows you to dream a little bit, huh, Tommy?
Oh, yeah, it definitely does. I mean, we thought we had a pretty good colt going to the year, and then to see what he's doing up to tonight, it's just, it's a fantasy.
And going into the final next week, Muscle Hill is clearly the horse to beat. Tell us what you guys, you, your father, and your whole family, everybody's thinking.
There's a lot of good colts that came up, and you know, this is, you know, we got him good for the Houghton, then he sat for about a month, and then we got him good for Lexington, and he sat for about a month and a half. Now hopefully he comes back and he's good, you know, for next week too. So we're confident.
Let me ask Greg Peck about those two gaps. It's tough to have gaps in a horse's schedule, but the Muscle Hill doesn't seem to mind.
Yeah, it's good to have patient owners too. They really let me do what I want. Do we actually seem to agree each time on what we would do with the schedule? And he's had to get ready three times, and it isn't easy because with the weather change, and it worried me tonight. I noticed a lot of horses on the lead were not holding up.
And he just kind of laughed off pressure here. Muscle Hill has got that special look since we first saw him, and nothing's changed in November.
No, he's always had that look, and he's kind of had it from day one, and everything's worked out well. But there's some good horses in that next division. You've got another one that's come along, Explosive Matter, that looks good, and Federal Flex has come down from Canada. So you know what they say, it comes down to the Breeders' Crown.
Yeah, Muscle Yankee won the Hamiltonian this year with a horse called Dewey Cheatham and Howe. That means there could be two in a row next year, maybe. Possibly. What do you think?
Let's hope so. We're dreaming about it.
Okay, Greg Peck, thanks a lot. Tommy Pontone, Lou Pontone, Muscle Hill has dominated in the Breeders' Crown Limit.